And that's how I programmed the blood particles. I think it really contributed to the visceral pleasure of Vicious Galaxy 2, making it the obvious standout in the series. My only gripe with the game was the designs of the characters. They're too old. Everyone wanted the same boring space marines from Vicious Galaxy 2. Eventually, I got my wish. There was some sort of breach within GameWorks. A lot. I had to create a new squad of player characters from scratch after that. Irving got weird. He told me that I might be in danger. Danger from what? And now we find ourselves at the climax of Walk. The player has to use everything they've learned to solve the ultimate puzzle and arm the bomb. Go on, you can do it. This probably looks daunting. Switches, those creepy eye things, and a splitter all in one puzzle. But it's the last one, I promise. I had to lower the difficulty of that puzzle like 10 times before the average player could solve it. But great job, you figured it out. You win. And that brings us to the present. Well, I should say, the near future. The other indie games coming out right now are crap, so Walk is a shoo-in for Game of the Year. This scene is a little glimpse into what's to come. The end. Thanks for playing, I guess. At this point, you just have to walk toward the white doorframe and the credits roll. And hey, I'm glad you turned on the developer commentary. I hope my story was as much an inspiration to you as it is to me. This is Lionel Snill, signing off. Did you get all that? Alright, good. Let's get out of here.